Greetings, fellow vapers. Spacekitty here. When I heard that the ECF and Vaping Guides were having a contest, I thought I might give it a go, because they had some wonderful prizes up for grabs, 15 of them to be exact. And offered by some really great sponsors too. In fact, Cig Easy said they would give a special bonus prize to any winner who mentions their name. But at first they could not decide on what to call the contest: funny films for fat bats, mad movies for mods, vacuous vaping videos. Until they finally settled on silly videos for serious prizes, not much of an improvement, if you ask me. And then they kept changing the rules as they went along. Men can be so fickle, you know. And what is it with these boys and their toys? Building these mods, big battery-operated devices, that look like something you would find in a girl's nightstand drawer. In fact, I went to one of our local vapor meets recently, and the things everyone had laid out on the tables reminded me of those home parties the girls used to have. You remember, don't you? The ones we nicknamed with a four-letter word that starts with F, ends with K, and rhymes with Tupperware. How about some of the names they give those things? The Ego. The Maximum. The Titan. While the Phidias Woodenus Maximus could be a vapor's answer to Viagra, the Golden Greek sounds like some sort of new fetish. And the Drip Tip, a condition for which one should seek immediate medical attention. And what's up with the Chuck? A badger in a prom dress sounds more like a Disney remake of Carrie, if you ask me. Then we have the little sister and the big brother. And of course there is always the wet box, don't even get me started on that one. So in the end, bigger is not always better. Just ask the ladies and they will tell you what we have known all along. It's not what you've got, it's how you vape it.